Good morning, students. This is Sunil Suryavanshi. Today we are going to learn the fourth lesson of standard 9. That is, have you thought of the verb have? We know have is a primary auxiliary. It means have can be used as a helping verb as well as a main verb. Have you ever thought about this, that how many times do we use the verb have in our day-to-day life within 15 to 20 minutes? You may do the practical and make a record of this. So students, we will start learning the uses of have. The first use of have, it indicates possession or ownership of something. Examples: my friend has a pet cat. Possession. So see, in this example, the subject is third person singular number, my friend. So we have to use has. If the subject of the sentence is third person singular number, it means he, she, it, or single name, then we have to use has. And if the subject is I, we, you, they, or any plural name, so we have to use have. So in the first sentence, the subject is my friend singular number, so we used has. The second sentence, my brother has a car. In this sentence also, has is used as the subject is my brother. It shows the position or the ownership. Third sentence, Ram has a novel. Again the same, subject singular has shows the position. I have a new pen. It is read as I have a new pen. But in actual English, we say, I have a new pen. So here the subject is have, because the have is used because I is the subject, it is singular person. Do you have a cycle? Our school has 6 computers. It shows the ownership. I have 2 pencils. With a bus. My father has a laptop. The municipality has 6 vans and 2 cars. In all these examples, one may see that have is used in present tense. There are 2 forms of have. They are have and has. So has is used for singular and have is used for plural. Now we will see the next use of have. In that next use of have, it indicates relationships or examples. But before going to the second use of have, you may read the examples again and find out the use of have and has for position or ownership. So see the second use, that is, in some cases have is used to indicate relationships. The first example, I have 2 sisters. So I have 2 sisters means I have 2 sisters. It shows that relation. The second example, the lady has 2 children. Again, it shows the relation. In a negative sentence, we use do with have and does with do or does. So I don't have a brother. She has a baby. The negative sentence of this one will be, she doesn't have a baby. It means in negative sentence there will be only have. Has will not be used in a negative sentence. My friend has a little sister. In this example we see, again the subject is third person, singular number, so we have used has. See the examples. I have two sisters. The lady has two children. I don't have a brother. She is a baby. Means she has a baby. My friend has a little sister. Now we will go to the third use of have. That is, we also use have to refer eating or drinking examples. It shows that have is used instead of eating or drinking also. First example, we have breakfast at 8 a.m. So this have indicates eat. Instead of saying we eat breakfast at 8 a.m., one can use we have breakfast at 8 a.m. Second example, have a slice of cake means eat a slice of cake, eat a piece of cake. The third example, what would you like to have? Tea or coffee? In such type of WH questions, also we can use have. Fourth, can I have a glass of water, please? While making request in the form of interrogation, also one can use such type of sentences. You can have these chocolates. So see, have can be used instead of eating to refer to drinking or eating. One may say, have a cup of tea, please. Now we will go to the next use of have. That is, we also use have to refer to events, activities, and experiences. Whenever we want to mention such type of activities, events or experiences, one can use such examples. See, I am reading the examples. I am going to have a bath in the river. So, here, have is used to mention the activity or experience. Let's have a party for your birthday. So, have is used to mention the events. The class has a short break at 11 a.m. for events, for experiences. Did you have a good time at the wedding? For experiences. I have a meeting this evening. I have a meeting this evening. For events also we can use have. The next use of have is also used to refer to a medical or physical condition. Example, I have a headache, means I have headache. Means there is a pain in my head. So have is used for medical or physical condition also. He's cold, means he has a cold. Grandfather had a heart attack. My brother has fever. That girl has migraine. So in all these examples, five examples, one may see that this have is used to show the condition. What type of condition? Medical condition. So these are the various uses of have. Now we will see where have is not used. In sentences where have is used as a main verb, it is always used in the simple present or past. The present continuous form is not used in such cases. We do not say, I am having a bicycle. He is having a coat. I am having a lot of homework. Similarly, it is not used in the negative form as a main verb, like he hasn't a car, I haven't a coat. To indicate the negative, we use the auxiliary do along with the main verb have. He doesn't have a car, I don't have a coat, they don't have any car, my friend doesn't have a book. It shows that whenever we want to make use of have in a negative sentence, we must use the forms of to do while making negative or interrogative sentences. If the subject of the sentence is third person, singular number, we have to use does. Thank you.